speaker e degli ospiti internazionali che saranno con noi durante il CodeMotion Roma, l'avventura che sarà online dal 9 al 12 di aprile, appunto a Roma. E abbiamo l'opportunità oggi di conoscere un grande imprenditore, una persona che sa davvero che cos'è l'innovazione, dato che ha lavorato nella Silicon Valley per più di 10 anni. Lo vedete con i suoi meravigliosi Google Glasses sul naso. Benvenuto, Alain Regnier. Welcome, Alain. Welcome with us.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you. I'm very glad to have you at our CodeMotion Room. Let's start immediately talking about your experience in the Silicon Valley. What does it mean, innovation, second your opinion, second your experience?
So yes, I did spend 10 years in Silicon Valley, and actually when I moved there, I thought I would stay for 1 or 2 years, but I found out that innovation was everywhere, and that's one of the main reasons I stayed for 10 years. So to me, innovation can mean different things. For example, way to make life easier or to make life more enjoyable. But it's also and mainly to be able to do things that we couldn't do before. To me, that's really what innovation is. And yes, Silicon Valley is probably one of the best places on earth to see innovations, new technologies, new startups popping up every day all around yourself and meeting new people with new ideas. That's really the most enjoyable part for me of living in Silicon Valley.
You are wearing something that really represents innovation. I'm talking, of course, about your Google glasses. So, what would you like to talk about them? What's the best and the worst feature that you find in these glasses?
So the Google Glass is, first, I have nothing really to do with the Google Glass at the beginning. I've been lucky enough to be part of the Glass Explorer program and to be one of the first to get them and to start doing development on them. The Google Glass to me are really an advanced smartphone that you can wear on your face and that allows you to do things without your hands. Of course, you can talk to them, but you can also use them very easily, having your hands free. And that's the best thing, I think, about the glass. Whereas if you use a smartphone, you always have to have your smartphone in one hand and use the other hand to control it. The worst thing right now, of course, is the battery life. The battery doesn't last a full day. It's a prototype. I'll talk more about that during CodeMotion Roma. But this is really the worst part, I think.
About the normal life with Google Glasses, I read something about the reaction of the people that is not always so welcoming. Sometimes talk about this, the people with these Google Glasses like a sort of cyborg, more or less what happened with the headphones, the Bluetooth headphones some years ago. So, what's your opinion? How does people look at you?
So it's interesting. I'd say it depends where you wear them. Most people don't really know them yet. And when they see me, they think, wow, this guy has some sort of gadget on his face, you know, whatever. But some people do recognize the glass or they understand that those are smart glasses. I guess the worst part for some of them is the fact that I can take pictures of them. Very easily without even having to take my smartphone out of my pocket. But to be honest with you, I've never really had any bad reaction to me wearing the glasses. Most of the people who recognize it, they either ask me, you know, how is it? What do you think? Or they just, you know, look the other way because they think I'm gonna record a video of them, which of course I won't be doing because it will use my battery way too much. But so yeah, no, I think people just need to get used to it. Maybe we'll have to do something about the camera, maybe put some cache in front of it so that people are not frightened that we will be recording them all the time. But other than that, I've had very good reaction from people.
Do you think that people are ready for the Google Glasses? And do you think that Google Glasses are ready for a mass use?
So to me, the Google Glass is really more a platform than a product at this point. And what I have on my nose right now is one of the first iteration of a product based on that platform. I'm not sure it will be sold in this present iteration, it could be slightly different or very different. I don't really know. The current prototype is actually very light and very useful, but what's really missing so at this point are applications. And that's why there are a lot of people like me doing development right now. And my bet is when the glass will be released to the public, you will be able to download and install application like you do today on your smartphone. And that's what's going to make the success of the glass. The second factor, which I think is important, is the price. We don't know exactly at which price it will be sold. There are some rumors around 300, 400 euros, which would be okay. But of course, if it's more expensive than that, it may take some time to get adopted. But I have no doubt that eventually the smart glasses form factor will change our life and will be a big revolution.
I think that will be, probably it will, yeah. And how do you present them at our CodeMotion event?
Yeah, so I plan to talk first to do an introduction about the glass, explain what we can do with them, how they work, to show some example of applications that have already been developed or presented, and also talk a bit about how we can actually program them and let our creativity really thrive through the use of those glasses from Google. That's pretty much what I'm going to be talking about.
That sounds really interesting. I don't want to miss your talk. Okay. I think that Google Glasses and your experience, of course, show us a big font of inspiration. Is there a sentence, a quote, that really inspired you in past that you want to share with our followers?
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Well, there is one. I don't actually remember exactly the quote, but it's a quote from Leonardo Vinci. I'm a private pilot, and I love flying. And the quote says something like, "Once you've tested flying, you always look at the sky and want to go back flying again." And I think it's pretty good for innovation. Once you've tested innovation, you really want to be part of it, and you really want to innovate more. That would be the quote. Sorry, I don't remember exactly the quote, but
it's very famous, and I perfectly understand what are you talking about.
Okay,
you were right. Okay, thank you very much, Alain. Thank you to be here. Would you like to say something to our CodeMotion people?
Well, thank you, and I'm looking forward to meet you guys at CodeMotion Roma next month.
Thank you. Thank you, Alan. Thank you again.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.